Hey, welcome to the third video of loyalty program. In this video, we're going to go through customizing the loyalty and editing the loyalty from start to the end and activating the loyalty if you're a first-time user. So let's get to the account. Now, I'm going to choose amount spent. You can choose visit made or cashback, whatever works for your business. And let's get started with this one. This is a quick preview about how the loyalty will actually work. I'm going to select edit loyalty. Now these are some guide that will help you throughout the process. Now over here, the first option is of editing the theme. You can upload your own logo and you can change the banner. So I'm going to keep a burger and I can change the theme color. So I want to pick something from my logo. So I'm just going to pick, say, this color, and I want a little darker font. So I'm gonna quickly set this. I'm gonna change the font to close to black and I'm done. The second option is to edit the points. Now this is where you can decide how much of a point will a customer get for each rupee that they spend. So I'm gonna keep it 1 rupee spent equals to 1 point, and I'm going to move to stages where I'm gonna set different rewards for the customer. So the first stage, I'm good with 300 points and I want to give them a free item, and I'm going to select one veggies on us. So the first time they visit and if they have 300 points, they're going to get a free veggies. The second stage, I'm going to increase this to 600 and change the reward type to a cash discount. So I'm going to give them, I'm going to change it to a discount, and I'm going to give them a 10% discount on the entire purchase. You can also select specific products if you want to, but I'm going to go with the entire purchase. The third stage, I want to select, I'm going to increase this to 1200, and I'm going to select this as a cash discount, and I want to give them a discount of 101 rupees on the entire purchase. I'm going to add one more stage. You can have as many stages as you want for the rewards. So now this is where I want customer to really save and visit me for the fifth time and collect a lot of points so that they can get a huge reward in against this. So this I'm going to keep it 2500. And it's going to be a free item, and I'm going to give them get a BOGO item on the entire menu. So it's going to be one-on-one. I'm good with these details. Now I'm going to change the terms and conditions. These are some suggestive terms and conditions that you can choose. You can also have your custom. So I'm going to also select not redeemable on public holidays. So my loyalty type is all set. You also have an option to change what you want to call your loyalty. So if you don't want to call it points, you can call it anything else. If you want to call it, say, chilies or anything that you know it's more relevant and more catchy for your business. I'm going to continue with the points and let's go to the next one. Now the next one is that when customer is making a purchase, you're only making the phone number mandatory for them, but you can also give them a reward so that they fill up the entire profile. So you want their birthdays and you want their anniversaries and email ID. So you can provoke them to fill all these details, and against that they're gonna get 100 bonus points. So I'm gonna keep this option enabled for now. Going forward to the step three, which is about setting up points reminder and points expiry. Now points reminder is, for example, a customer has not visited you for the last 30 days, then you can send a small reminder for the customer to come back and make a purchase with you. You have options to choose between days or weeks. So I'm keeping it 30 days for my restaurant. And there's also an option of point expiry. So for example, I have set a validity of my points for a customer. So say my points are valid only for 2 months after the last purchase, or I want to keep the validity as say 6 months. So I'm going to go with the 6 months. So basically, if a customer has not visited me for 6 months from the last purchase, then 14 days prior to that, they will get a reminder message that, you know, the points are about to get expired and, you know, you should just come back and visit us and make a purchase. Going to the fourth step, This fourth step is about the channel of communication. So I want to tell customer that I have a loyalty program. So what channels and what mediums do I want to use? So the best is that if you're choosing WhatsApp, you don't need to set up an SMS. So that's the correct combination. So you can go with WhatsApp and email. If you think that a lot of customers don't read emails, you can just uncheck that. And for now, I'm going to keep WhatsApp and email. And in the next video, I'm going to also show you what kind of a communication the customer receives. Now, before I set this loyalty, I say want to test this loyalty. So this is an option where you can actually add your own mobile number and test how the loyalty will look like before you actually activate it. So it's like a quick check that everything is as per your need. And going to the fifth step, I want to continue without testing. Now, fifth step is a quick preview about what's the loyalty that is going to you are going to enable. So there are four stages. I'm good. The terms and conditions are good. I'm also okay with the three options. So now I'm all set to activate my loyalty.